Now quickly we will see the banking sector. Okay, we may not go that much detail into the the banking sector as like in the civil services. Yeah. So here RBI, who is the present governor of the RBI, Shaktikanta Das. Okay. So Urjit Patel resigned in between and he ran away. Okay. So what is the main purpose of the RBI? Okay, RBI is like the, it will provide money to the government. Money supply, it will provide the money supply. Money supply means it is for the government and as well as for the banks. Okay, and generally it will print all the money except 1 rupee. Okay, and then it will monitor the banks. Okay, it will monitor like what is the governance they are following. How much bad loans they are having, NPA. See, especially when Raghuram Rajan was the governor of the RBI, he used to, you know, chase these banks which are having very, you know, huge NPA. NPA means non-performing assets. Okay, that means bad loans. So, they always monitor this, how the bank performance is there and how it is governing and what is the transparency level, whether it is following the rules and the regulations stipulated by the RBI. So it will monitor that, and apart from that it will also continuously give the advices, like whenever there are best practices available, then it will advise the banks to do that. So if the question is asked like what is the main purpose of the RBI, so it covers everything. Okay, so generally there are different types of banks in India. So the main classification is a scheduled and non-scheduled bank. Okay, it is not that much a difficult classification. See, Reserve Bank of India Act enacted in 1932. So even before the independence. Okay, so when they enacted, so in that law, you know, the banks which are mentioned in the second schedule of that law, you know, are called as the banks, you know, are called as the scheduled banks, whichever banks, you know, mentioned in that second schedule. So generally, what are the banks those are mentioned here? See, what is the conditions to mention in this schedule? You know, the minimum paid up capital is 5 lakhs. What is the meaning of that? When you are starting a bank, the minimum amount that you need to keep in the bank is minimum is 5 lakhs. Okay, and whenever you know these are mentioned in the scheduled, in the scheduled second schedule of the act, and if it is called as a scheduled bank, then it is a it can avail the loan, from the RBI. Okay, and non-scheduled banks are which are not mentioned in the second schedule, and these are very small banks and even sometimes less than the 5 lakhs rupees paid up capital, and these are not they cannot avail the loan from the Reserve Bank. Okay, and again here the scheduled bank is further divided into the commercial and cooperative bank. Commercial and cooperative, even in the non-schedule also it can be commercial and cooperative, but generally if you can take like that, it is a scheduled bank. Banks are again divided into commercial and cooperative. In the name itself, it is a, the meaning is there in the name itself. For example, in the commercial, what is the meaning of the commercial? That means it is a profit motive. That means these are these banks are for the making the profit. Okay, and this is like a non-profit. Non-profit. For example, here if you take SBI, Canara, or ICICI Bank, all other like again in the commercial bank we have different types of banks. What is that? Government banks. Okay, that means it is owned by the government, and a private bank, that means it is owned by the private entities. If the share 51% of the share is owned by some any individual, then it will become the private bank. And foreign banks, that means the banks which are mainly operated in foreign and they set up their branches here in the India, foreign banks. Okay, there are different types of banks again there in the commercial banks. Okay, and here the main motive is profit, and the cooperative And here, the cooperative banks, actually, these are, you know, non-profit and these are registered with the, you know, Cooperative Society of India. Okay. And here, generally, these cooperative banks, you might have heard, right? Cooperative banks, again, there are two types. Okay. Urban cooperative and rural cooperative. Rural. Okay. First. In the rural, especially if you go to rural bank and if you ask any farmer that whether you know the cooperative bank or not, then definitely they will say that yes, I know the cooperative bank and I have taken this much of loan from the cooperative bank. Okay, so the cooperative bank is mainly for the farming purpose in case of a rural or a cooperative bank. And in the urban, generally it will help the businessman means, you know, some business and then corporations. Okay, in rural, this is the main for the farming. Most of the farmers take, you know, loan from the cooperative bank, rural cooperative bank, and whenever government you know, promise them to waive off their farm loan, then the cooperative bank only suffer means government will give money, it will compensate, you know, money to the cooperative bank. And apart from these banks, you know, these days so many other banks are also coming. Okay, even there is one more bank like RRB, Regional Rural Bank. Okay, that means, you know, in the rural area, see, the penetration of all these cooperative or rural banks are less. So in that case, in such cases, you know, they establish this not only helps the farming and even, you know, small and medium scale industries also, it will help, you know, the rural regional bank. And after that, again, we have, you know, payment bank. We will see what is that payment bank means it is not full-fledged banking facility, like it cannot lend money to the others, but it will take the deposit only up to the 1 lakh, and it can issue the credit card and it can be used in the different ATMs also. Okay, and the small financial banking, so many other banks are coming. So apart from that, these are the main, you know, banking types. Okay, so in order to go that much detail into this, and here in this chapter, what we need to see what are the different, how the RBI control the money flow in the market by using the different, instruments. Okay, so why it needs to control, first of all, the money control in the market. For example, you might have here like inflation and then sometimes a deflation. Okay, we rarely hear this deflation in Indian scenario, but we always hear the inflation. Inflation means, what is the inflation? You know, inflation means presently, you know, onion prices have skyrocketed, like something like 150 or 180 rupees per kg. So if daily consumables like onions or pulses, if these prices are, you know, going very high, then it is very difficult to buy, even petrol prices. So that means, you know, if the prices of the items are increasing more and more, then it will lead to the inflation. That means more people are choosing the less goods. Okay. Generally, inflation is having two sides. For example, if I take let's say onions, more people want to eat it. Okay. So, but there is a shortage. How? There is a demand shortage. Demand side and the supply side. What is the demand side? Demand side means, you know, previously, let's take, you know, only 1 crore people are eating the onions. Now, something like 5 crore people started eating the onion. Why? Because they also got the money and they also try to buy. That means the demand for the onion increased here a lot. Because of that, when more people are trying to buy the less items, you know, less available items, then what happens? Price increases. That is one cause here. And the other cause is the supply side. What is the supply side? For example, previously, you know, you are able to meet the demand required for all 5 crore people. But now, because of the bad crop or monsoon failure or whatever it is not a monsoon crop, I'm just telling you, like, because of the bad crop season, then what happened? It is unable to meet the demand for 5 crore, but only it can meet only up to 2 crore people. Then there is a 3 crore people deficit. Okay, everyone is having money, but only we have supply, limited supply. In that case, what happens? The people who have you more money, you will sell to them. That is what is happening here. So, most of the time, okay, the RBI can take care about this demand side, but not the supply side. Okay, here in this particular scenario. Okay, sometimes you can take care about the supply side also. Okay, so here, what is happening? If I can reduce the money available with the persons, then what happened? I can decrease the demand here. For example, here, you know, 5 crore people are having the money to buy the onions. 5 crore means everyone is employed and they are earning more and they want to spend more. Then what happened? I will somehow twist the economy so that the amount of money available with this person will reduce. Then there are only 2 crore people, you know, are able to buy this. Then what happened? The cost will come down. Okay, that is the one way of controlling the inflation. Okay, so in case of onion, it is okay. For example, there are something like a, you know, 1 lakh car. 1 lakh cars are available. Okay, so what is happening? 1 lakh car. You know, more and more people are, the demand increased. Demand increased. When will the demand increase? Demand increase when more and more people are having the money here. More money. When will they have money? When they have a job. Job means, you know, earnings. When will they have the job or earning? When the economy is good. Economy, when is the economy good? When there are more industries that are providing jobs to the people. Okay. That means more industry. Okay, and when is the more industry thrive? When will the industry thrive? They have enough capital or investment. Okay, and they have investment. From where this investment come? Okay, if he is, no one is having that much money on his own. So they need to take money from the bank. They need to take money from the bank. So here, if the demand for a car is increasing, then what happened? Money also increased. I mean, it's a cost is increasing. Cost is increasing. Then what is happening? What is the root cause? The root cause is here is a bank here. Bank means if a bank is reducing the amount of money that is going into the industry, then what is happening? The industry may not expand. That means it will cut the job. When it cut the job, some people lose the, you know, their job, or they may not have that much money to buy the car. Like that, you know, it is controlling in a negative way. That is why it is always conflicting. Okay. See, here, if you are not allowing industry to expand, then what is happening? The economy is coming down. Even the prices are coming down. But government is against that. Why? Because government wants to, you know, increase the economic growth rate, and then they want to produce more and more jobs. Okay. That is why always there is a clash between the RBI governor and the, you know, finance minister. Unless RBI governor, he try to control the money in the economy. Okay, then this fellow comes and says, like a finance minister say, like, oh, okay, don't tighten that much. Okay, so because ours is a developing country, under this much inflation is okay. When inflation is there, that means more people are willing to buy something. Okay, there is a demand. That means people are having money. Then they produce more cars. If more people are buying, then what is happening? They will produce more car, and then it will expand. Since it is an example for the car, you know, RBI doesn't care much about this. RBI care only when there is a CPI, consumer price index is increasing. That means, you know, pulses and then, you know, edible oil or onion cost, these type of consumable items are, cost of the consumable items are increasing, then in that case it will take, you know, try to tighten the grip on the economy. Okay, RBI. So that is inflation. That means we need to reduce the cost of the items. So whenever the cost of item is increasing, then it causes the inflation. And what is the deflation? When the it is opposite of inflation, that means the cost of the item reduces here. So you may think that it may be good for the economy. No. You know, consistent deflation is not good for the economy. What is happening here? So what happens if the cost of the item decreasing? For example, you know, let's take onion, same onion. So what is happening? 1 kg onion is something like 5 rupees only. 5 rupees. Okay. Then compared to other crop, if it is yielding only 5 rupees, if it is fetching only 5 rupees, then who will produce the onion here? No one will produce. They will move on to the other. In the same way, okay, the cell phone cost is only 2000 or 3000, and if the cost of production is something like 4000 rupees, then who will produce the cell phone? They will stop it, okay, over the period. That means when they stop that, then production will stop and job loss will be there, and there is no development in the economy, okay, there is no job creation. That is why inflation is okay, little bit of inflation, but not too much of inflation. Always inflation will be there. And if you observe, the rate of inflation is very, very high in case of developing countries or the emerging economies. But whereas if you take the developed countries, you know, the inflation is very, very, the increasing the inflation that from 1 year to the next year is very, very small, okay, stagnant. It is almost stagnant because the development rate also, or the growth rate also very less there. Okay, so that is the deflation. And how to control this RBI? By using the money it will control. That is why it is called as the monetary policy. And who will adopt this? The RBI will adopt, RBI governor. Okay, so these are divided into quantitative and as well as the qualitative. Quantitative means, you know, controlling the quantity of the money. That is why it is called as the quantitative. The first one is a reserve ratio. Okay. So what is the reserve ratio? What is the reserve ratio? In the reserve ratio, we have two terms. What is that? You know, SLR. SLR. SLR means statutory liquidity ratio. Okay. Statutory liquid ratio or liquidity ratio. So what is the meaning of that? You know, this is the something like the amount of money, you know, that bank should deposit with the RBI. Okay. Money deposit with the RBI. It is to avoid the risk. Okay. So I gave you permission to set up a bank. For example, you set up a bank, then what happens? People came and they invested something like 100 crores in our bank. Then what happened? Next day, you will turn your board and then run away from here. Then no one can catch you. So, to avoid such type of scenario, then what happened? There is a statutory liquidity ratio. It is not only for that, even in the emergency cases, you know, you can claim this money to settle also. So, the money deposited with the RBI with the from the bank. Okay. Next one is the CRR. This is called as the cash reserve ratio. Okay, this much liquidity you need to keep in the bank. For example, bank A is there, otherwise SBI bank is there. SBI bank. Okay. Money kept with the bank for any unforeseen, you know, exigencies, like emergencies. See here, when I say the money deposit with the RBI, it need not be the money. That means it could be any, you know, gold or, you know, government securities. Securities means, you know, bonds. Anything, okay? Anything which is having the value equivalent to that, okay, which is having a value. For example, gold means if you sell in the open market, you know, RBI will recover that money. Okay. So, see here, generally, let's say, this is something like a 20%, and this is something like a 5%. Okay. Let's assume that it is 20% and this is 5%. And SBI, what is happening? SBI got a something like a, how much? 100 crores deposit in it. Okay, out of 100 crores, then now SLR is a, how much? 20 crore. You need to keep a 20 crore with the SBI. RBI. And then CRR is a cash reserve ratio that you need to keep within your bank. I mean, in the SBI. How much? 5 crore. This should be in the SBI itself. Okay. But you cannot utilize this for the lending. Okay. For lending, you cannot utilize this for the lending. You need to keep that. And you don't get any profit or interest on this. Okay. You just park that money in your bank somewhere. Okay. So, what is the remaining? Remaining is how much? Only, 75 crores. So, only 75 crores is available for the lending. Okay. How banking sector is making profit? From the interest rate. Okay. If you lend, then only you will get money. If you don't lend, then you won't get any money. Okay. You don't get anything. So, what is happening? 75 crores. That is what happens. Okay. So, bank sector, what is happening in banking? In bank, so the 75, bank, how is it is making the profit? For example, 100 crore deposited. When the depositor, they charge some, they will offer something like, interest rate, how much in their savings bank, let's take, 6% they are offered. Okay, when they lend, interest rate, interest rate is something, let's say 10% to 12%, even 13-14%. For example, if you go for any home loan or a car loan, they will charge 12% or 11.5%. Okay, that much they are almost double the amount they charge. That, then only they are getting that much money. Okay, yes. So here, what is happening? The RBI will rise this limit. If RBI is rising this limit, okay, then what is happening? If it rises this limit, SLR and then CRR, then what is happening? If it is rising, 20 will become 25. 20 will become 25 SLR, and then CRR 5 may become 10. If it rises the limit, instead of 20, it is a 25%, instead of 5, it may become 10%. Then what is happening? 35 here itself gone. Okay, then how much remaining? Only 65 crore remaining. When 65 crore is remaining, then what is happening? It need to lend the money to the people, and it no longer can lend at 10%. Okay, it need to get the same amount of profit. For example, it need to run its business, it need to get the same amount of profit. But the amount of money that is available for lending is decreased now. Then in that case, what happened? It will increase the interest rate. Here it will increase the interest rate, something like 15%. Then what happened? The business people or whoever borrowing the money, they will calculate their break-even and everything, their profit. For example, if money is coming at that much costly interest rate, then they may not get enough profit. Okay, if the cost of the product is very high, not many people will buy that. Then they think everything, and then they may not expand the business. When they don't expand, then what happen? There are not many job holders, or the money in the economy will decrease automatically. Okay. So when money is decreased, then what happens? The inflation or demand for the goods will decrease. If you don't have money, you can't buy anything, right? So the inflation will decrease. Why we are reading all this? How RBI is using monetary policy to decrease the inflation here? That is what we are seeing. And out of that, three possible options, and I have taken the first one. What is that? A reserve ratio. Why it called as reserve ratio? That means I am reserving some of the money. Okay, by increasing this percentage, then what is happening? The inflation is decreasing. Okay, this is the one case. And what is the next one? Open market operation. Okay, what is the open market operation? Open market operation means buying or selling of the government securities. Okay, what is the security? Many times we are using security or bond. Okay, so security or bond is a, sometimes it's called as a bond also, security, that's there. Security is something like a government bond. government say like, okay, this is a piece of paper. Okay, on the paper it will write, government will write like, oh, this is equivalent to the 1 lakh rupee. It is a 1 lakh rupee. Okay, you buy this 1 lakh rupee paper and they give me 1 lakh rupees to me. Okay, and after 1 year, at the rate of 8% interest, okay, I pay back whatever amount, you know, how many bonds you, whatever you secure, how many secure, whatever security you have. Okay, that means here what is happening? RBI on behalf of the government issuing the securities, government security on behalf of the government. Okay, security is coming here. And SBI is buying, SBI or you know, ICICI is buying these securities. Okay, when they buy, what is happening? The money will go there. Money go to RBI. Money go to RBI and the security is coming to this. Okay, that means the amount of SBI is having, how much is previously, how much money is having? Only, you know, 75 crores at the rate of SLR 20% and 5% of CIR. Only 75 crores are there. And out of 75, it is buying this security and it lost something like 20 crores. Then how much it is having? Only 55 crores. Okay, 20 crores gone here. Then the lending capacity of the SBI decreased. Okay, then in that case, what is happening? You know, it will increase the, it may not lend to the more people and also it may increase the, you know, the lending interest rate also. Okay, in that case, what is happening? The expansion of the business will stop and again, you know, the economy will decrease and then there are not much jobs and there are no jobs and no money with the people and they cannot purchase more. When they are not purchasing more, then automatically inflation will come down here. Okay. That is the one thing. Instead of RBI buying this, you know, RBI selling this securities, if it is buying back from the bank, then what happens? It will release more and more money to the bank, then they will, you know, disperse loans to the more companies. Okay. When will it will do? Whenever it feels like the inflation is under control. And to spur the economic growth, then what happens? RBI will, you know, pump in more amount of money. That is what happened. If you see, if you you know, you might have said, you know, observed like that during the 2008 you know recession, and even sometimes you might have heard like a Chinese government pumped this much of these many billions of money into the market, or US federal bank, you know, pumped this much of amount of money into the you know, what is that, market. Okay, then what happened? When RBI or any other central bank is giving, or government is giving money to the bank, then they have more capacity to lend and they will lend to anyone. Okay, if someone comes and asks like, I am starting a business, then okay, you will take the money and you do business like that, they will distribute to everyone. Okay, then everyone start becoming entrepreneur and they will employ the people and then economy increase. Okay, that is why whenever the growth of the economic growth is very less, then they will pump in so much of money into that. Okay, and the next one is the policy rate. In the policy rate, you know, generally there are like a bank rate. What is the bank rate? Whenever you know bank borrow money from the RBI give money to the bank. Okay, then in that case, and this is a long term loan and without any collateral or any guarantee, you know, RBI give money to the bank. In such cases, you know, the amount of interest rate it is charging is called the RBI. Okay, here also we get again reported these, here also same definition, but here what is happening? Here there is no collateral guarantee or no collateral non-collateral or no guarantee, and it is a long term. So what happened obviously here, if the bank rate is increased, then very few banks will come and take the money from it, and then they may not give money to the in that way, in the availability of money with the bank will be reduced. And the next important is this one, liquidity adjustment facility. Okay, liquidity means it is a cash. liquidity adjustment facility. Okay, for example, you know, if you want money in the short run, then what happen? You know, repo rate is there. Repo rate. So it is called as the repo rate. What is the repo rate? You know, the RBI lending rate to the bank. Okay, here bank means not only banks. You know, it can give lending rate means, you know, banks, state government, central government, whoever want money, they can go to RBI. Okay, they can go to RBI and they can pledge their security. Security means government securities. Okay, like a bond given by particular institution. For example, if SBI is taking, then they will pledge these securities. Like they will sign so and so, after 1 year I will pay. How they pledge, let's say something like, you know, now you pay 100 rupees. You give me 100 rupees and you keep this paper with you. Okay, SBI is going to RBI and saying like, give me 100 rupees and you take this paper with you, and after 1 year I will pay 105. Okay, 105 rupees. Okay, what is the meaning of that? I will pay 5 rupees extra after 5 years, after 1 year. Okay, so this is very less, and for the sake of understanding, I'm saying. So what is this repo? What is this 105? That is a repo. Okay, repo means extra money you are getting, okay, after 1 year by giving 100 rupees now. That means here, what is the percentage? 105 minus 100 divided by 100, then it will become how much? 5%. 5% there, the repo rate is a difference divided by original one into the original one is a, you know, in terms of percentage. Okay, that is 5%. So if the bank, if I say that the bank repo rate is 5%, then this much interest rate they need to pay for this. And here it is a collateral, that is where we need to place the government of securities here. Okay. And then what is happening? And again, reverse repo. What is the meaning of that? If RBI is borrowing back the money from the banks, then whatever amount, you know, whatever percentage of interest rate they are charging, that is the reverse repo. The reverse repo. And generally here, reverse repo equal to repo minus 1%, repo rate minus 1%. Okay, generally this is less, this is less. Otherwise what happened here? This is what happened. Okay, bank went to RBI and then it got money. Okay, something like a 5% it charged. Then what happened? Again bank will give money to the RBI. So how much it should charge? It is repo rate. Repo rate is 5%. And here how much it should charge? Repo minus 1%. That means 4%. Okay. That means here bank, when a bank will take money from the RBI, then they need to utilize to give to the society and industry so that the economy will grow. Okay. That is why to discourage, you know, the money coming back and parking with the RBI, you know, the rate, this rate always should be less than the repo rate. Understood? Otherwise, if you, instead of 6%, then if it is something like 8%, then what happened? Bank will take money from the RBI at 5%, and again, the same money they will go and deposit in the RBI, then they will get 8%. That means, you know, they will get a 3% profit here itself. You go and take money from some fellow and you again lend the same money to him, get a more profitable interest rate, then it is nonsense, it is illogical. Okay, so that is why always, you know, reverse repo is less than the reverse repo rate, and that is by 1%. Okay, 1% means it is 100 basis points. Generally they call 100 basis points. Let's not go that much detail in there. Let's, you know, you remember only this. Okay. So here, repo is a reverse repo is a repo minus 1%. So here, what is happening? Central government or RBI will come and say that a repo rate will increase. If they say that a repo rate from 5%, if they increase to the 8%, then what happens? Not many banks will show interest to come and borrow money. When banks are not coming and showing, you know, showing the interest to borrow money, then its availability of money in the market will decrease, and automatically the demand for the good will decrease, then the inflation will come down here. Okay, that is the inflation here. And here sometimes we also see one more time. Okay, what is that? What is that one? That is the marginal standing facility. Okay, it is called as the marginal standing facility. So what is this marginal standing facility, MSF? MSF, marginal standing facility. This is also as like a repo rate. This is also as like a repo rate. So what is the repo rate? What is the repo rate? So when you are taking money from RBI to the any bank or government or central government or state government, then what happens? Something like a 5% or retail repo rate. Okay. So here also same thing. It is also when RBI is lending money, okay, to the bank SBI, then here also it is something like a generally 5% plus 1%. Why here plus 1%? You will tell. It is more than the repo rate generally. Here, what is happening? In case of RBI, repo rate, you know, it is available for the state and as well as central government, and then non-banking financial institutions, that means whoever take gold and whoever take your gold and give loan, that is a non-banking financial institution. They can't give any debit card or credit card, only they will give loan. Okay? And then here, but here whereas there it can be only to the banks. It is only to the banks. Okay, and here generally here you know. Generally here you know the minimum amount they say like if it is more than 5 crores, if you require more than 5 crores and above that, then only you come and I will charge repo rate. Here minimum amount is 1 crore also. Okay, and there you can take as much money as possible, and here you cannot take that, you know, it is something like 0.75% you know, limit on the total amount of deposits of the bank. Okay, and there in case of repo rate, you know, you cannot place the reserve ratio. What is the reserve ratio? Yes, reserve ratio, statutory liquid ratio, SLR, plus a CRR. We have two, cash reserve ratio and the statutory liquidity ratio. Okay, what are these two? These two are like a, if you remember, this is something like a 20 crore and this is a 5 crore. We have this 20 crore and a 5 crore, but we are not using anywhere this. We just kept 20 crore with RBI and 5 crores within our bank, and we are not using that, only we are keeping for the sake of any emergency. Okay, and to get this repo rate, you know, I need to place the securities. So security means, okay, I have this property. I will show this property and on that I will take the loan. Okay, like that I cannot show this property and take loan in case of repo rate. But whereas you cannot treat that as a security. Understood? But whereas in case of the marginal, you know, standing facility, you can show this. Okay, I kept up 20 crore in the RBI and 5 crore in my bank. Okay, I will show this as a security. Give me some money. If I am unable to pay, you can take that, like that. Okay, in case of that repo, you cannot take, but in case of here, you can pledge those SLR and CRR as a security here. Okay, that is why it is only in case of emergency. Emergency, if you want to need, you know, quickly some very big industrialist came to your bank. Okay, he said like, I will give you some money, my business will expand karega. Okay, but you don't have money immediately, and he is willing to pay even, you know, extra interest also. Then in that case, what happened? You will go to the Reserve Bank and you know, whatever, you will take some money. And even though here Reserve Bank is charging 1% extra compared to the repo, you will take that money and give to the industrialist. Okay, because you know, you may miss that party.
then he will pay monthly money, and compared to this, here how much? It will become 6% only. You can give that money to industrialized sector 13 to 14% interest, double the amount. Okay? That is the main purpose of this. So far, what we have seen? We have seen reserve ratio, open market operation, policy ratio. And see, out of this, you know, RBI only, most of the time, go for the policy rate. RBI go to the policy rate only. That means, most of the time, you might have heard, like RBI, I will increase the repo rate. If inflation is increased, I will increase the repo rate. Otherwise, I will decrease. Okay, most of the time, it will do like this only. Okay. So when it is increasing the repo rate, what is happening? Money supply to the banks will, you know, decrease. Otherwise, when repo rate is decreased, then money supply to the bank will increase. Okay, increase. So immediately, what happened? Based on these repo rates, you know, the money can be increased or decreased. But what is happening? How the bank charge from the customer or the borrower? How the bank charge? It is no way related to this repo rate. Okay, it is no way related to the repo rate. For example, there is a bank. Okay, so I went to the bank. I went to the bank and borrowing some money. Okay, so let's say repo rate is something like a 5%. So, repo rate is something like 8% and the bank interest rate is something like 12%. Okay. So, when I am borrowing this money, they are charging 12%, which is very costly loan for me. Then what happened? To spur the economic growth in the Indian market, RBI decreased the repo rate from 8% to the 5%. Okay. Initially 8%, from 8% it decreased to the 5%. Okay. Then what happened? There is no clear mechanism so that automatically, you know, here the bank, let's say SBI, if I take it, may not decrease the, you know, interest rate for the lending may not decrease. You know, ideally it should decrease from 12 to something like 10% or 9%. But it may not decrease. It can keep the same 12% because there is no obligation. There is no, you know, legal binding. Okay. So that is why what is happening, there is no transmission of the repo rate from the RBI to the banks. Okay, there is no transmission. Okay, that is why what is happening, that is one reason there is no transmission. And to avoid this, what is happening now, they are trying to change to the new, you know, transmission formula. What is that? See, how they came at 12%, it is their internal policy. They calculated how much expenditure, how much an operational cost, how much everything they calculated, and they came at a 12% interest rate. Okay, it is up to them. So, to, you know, pass on that, you know, reduce the effect of the repo rate, change in the repo rate, then what happened? They came up with some other, you know, concept. What is that? That concept is a marginal, that is called a MCLR, lending rate. Okay, what M stands for? Marginal cost of funds. C for cost of funds, marginal cost of funds, MC, based lending rate. So the lending rate is based on the marginal cost of funds. Okay, marginal cost of funds. Okay, marginal means it is a differentiated or a difference or whatever change that happened. And cost of fund means whatever it is. So basically, let's not go that much detail into that, but I will tell the important point about this. Okay, what is that? It is based on the risk of borrowers. For example, you see the risk. For example, if he is pledging the securities very strong and you know, something like that, then you can, you know, mitigate the risk of giving him. Okay. If he is not giving that much of security or guarantee, then the risk is high. And it is also based on the repo rate, and it is also based on the, you know, lending rate. Bank lending rate. Bank lending rate. Lending rate means here to the, you know, borrower. But when bank is lending to the RBI, it is a reverse repo rate. Okay, it cannot lend at 12%. It will take or forcefully take only the repo rate minus 1%. Okay, so it is mainly based on this one. So what they are trying to do is, you know, RBI will slowly implement this, you know, MCLR. So that what happened, it is connected to the repo rate. So whenever there is a change in the repo rate, then automatically, you know, this also will change. It, you know, remains, it may not be, you know, remain, you know, constant. Previously, unless they don't change, they can keep on use the 12%. But automatically, based on this, you know, it will also change. Slowly, they are trying to adapt to that. Okay. So here, what we learn, when RBI changes any of these three, then what happens? There is a change in the liquidity in the market. Okay. But how much change really happening here? For example, here, if you take the policy rate in India, for example, policy rate means repo rate. So whenever you know RBI is changing, whenever RBI is changing the repo rate, then what is happening? Not much change is happening in the, you know, economy. Not much change is happening. In India, not much change. Not much change. But various, if you take the US, US RBI is called as the US Federal Bank. Okay. So whenever it changes the interest rate, then what happens? There is a drastic change. Drastic change in the market. Drastic change. Even a small percentage will change a lot. Okay, why? Because why is that so? Generally, if you take the banking system in India, banking, what is happening? Most of the banks, you know, they will get the deposits from the savings account. Savings are the deposits. Okay. And less from RBI. Okay. Less from RBI. But whereas if you take the US, more banks will get more money, more from, you know, RBI or central. RBI means it is equivalent to the federal bank. Okay. So what is happening when you are getting more money from this federal bank, and whenever the federal bank changes some interest rate, then what will happen? Automatically there is more effect on the, you know, economy. But whereas here, if you are taking less money from the RBI and more from the, you know, depositors or customers to your bank, then there is a less change on the economy, even though repo rate is changing there. Okay. So here, why, you know, more savings are coming in Indian banks and very less savings in the US? Because in the America, they have other investment models, you know, different other investment opportunities, like, you know, you invest in the mutual funds or the shares, something like that you can do. But whereas in India, you know, we don't believe that much, you know. Many people may not trust, you know, investing in the shares. Okay, they want to save some money. So that is the one reason here. And here, if you observe, you know, RBI most of the time, you know, concentrating only on the policy rate by changing the repo rate. But why it is not doing by changing the reserve ratio? Okay. In the reserve ratio, what happened? If I increase the reserve ratio, then the amount of money left with the bank, you know, decreasing, decreasing. And out of this, now there is a priority sector lending, PSL, priority sector lending. You need to keep that much money definitely to those sectors, like, you know, agriculture or bank loans, and then, you know, small scale industries, like that you need to give to particular sectors there. Okay. So after, and especially before this, you know, economic liberalization that happened in 1990s in India, you know, you need to give the loan at a very low interest rate to this PSL. And after that, you left with only less amount of money. Okay. And you have a freedom to give the remaining money at a
you know, interest rate, you know, profitable interest rate. Okay, that means here, yeah, if you try to control the reserve ratio as they used to do, before this economic liberalization, then what happened? The amount of money that is available for lending is decreasing. Okay, so because of that, what is happening? It is adversely affecting the economic development. Okay, here, you know, because of the repo rate, what is happening? You know, the items are becoming costly, and you know, the amount is reducing. But here, bank itself is getting affected. That is why instead of going here, you know, RBI always try to screw, tighten the screw on the repo here. Okay, these are all the quantitative measures. And what are the quantitative measures? We see some of the qualitative numbers here. Okay, so what is that? Margin requirements. Okay, margin requirements. For example, margin requirements. What is the meaning of that? For example, you know, I went to the bank and asked for 1 crore rupee. And they say like whatever amount they ask, you give only, you deduct that and only give, you know, 50%. So when I ask for 1 crore, they will give only 50 lakhs. Okay, like that the banks are, you know, should maintain the margin in whatever they are asking for the loan. In that way, what happens? The amount of money you are, you know, lending will decrease. Okay, and then consumer credit regulation. Consumer credit regulation means, for example, what is the meaning of that? You just remember, you know, ESC gain and grow dimension. Instead of writing, asking these difficult words, they may give some example. Like what happens? For example, you know, if you increase the, you want to buy a car, okay, you want to buy a car, then what is happening? You know, if a car company is saying, if the car is something like 2 lakhs rupees, if car company is saying that you need to pay 50,000 rupees and remaining only bank can give, okay. In such cases, what happened? Very few people can come and take this. So if you decrease this 50,000, instead of only 10,000, then more people will come and purchase the car. Why? Because you pay only 10,000 and even you take the bank loan, okay, then you will pay the EMI. Otherwise, one more technique is increase the amount, minimum amount of EMI that needs to be paid. Something like, if I take something like 50,000, you need to pay every month EMI. Then not everyone can afford this. If your salary is 20,000 and if you need to pay 15,000 EMI every month, then you should not go. You definitely don't go for the buying the car. Okay. So like that, this type of consumer credit restrictions, by keeping that, you know, you can, you know, reduce some of this. Okay. And then credit control, moral, so many other things are there. We don't need to go that much detail. But here, our main objective of this lecture is to understand what is the repo rate and how banks, what are the meaning of different terms. Okay, here we got the SLR and then CRR, and here repo rate and then the reverse repo rate. Okay, and here open market, we got the, what is the security, what is the security, government securities, and we also see recapitalization bonds. Okay, that we see in the current affairs. Okay.